Harry, if that's the guy from downstairs, I have no idea how a satellite got hooked up to our cable. And if it's Dad, I'm still enrolled in college, and my professors find me amusing and delightful. Go ahead.
Hi, is Billy home?
Hi, Gina. This is my brother, Harry. Right now, he wishes he was taller.
Here are the photographs you wanted. Some I'm in lingerie, some I'm in a bathing suit, and I even threw in some sexy ones.
Well, thanks for dropping these by, and when I get some time, I'll look them over.
Okay, I'll see you later.
Bye-bye.
Hello.
So you like Gina, huh?
Hello.
Here, amuse yourself. Oh! Harry, with me as her manager soon, every man in Chicago will be babbling in that same exact way. See, I'm putting Gina on a billboard, just her picture and the word Gina. You know, I'm thinking talk shows, MTV, and if the gods are with us, she'll appear as the sassy cousin from Texas on Dr. Quinn Medicine Woman.
That is genius, genius, little brother. I'd hate to think you threw away 6 weeks of college for nothing.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Mike.
Billy, did you get a job yet? Well, at least you tried.
What are you doing downtown?
I'm bidding a contracting job over on Ashland.
Mike, do you mind if I come out and stay with you and Lisa and Cicero for like 2 or 3 days?
Careful with that 2 or 3 day stuff. I fell for that 6 months ago.
Billy, you can come and stay with me and Lisa as long as you want. No problem.
Yes.
There may be a problem.
No.
Lisa kind of decided we shouldn't be married anymore, which kind of sucks.
Joni loves Chachi.
Mikey, that's terrible. Sit down. What the hell happened?
I mean, how could Lisa kick you out? I mean, were you seeing another woman or something?
What are you, nuts? She's my whole life.
Thank you. Well, then tell us what went wrong.
No.
Was something you did? Something you didn't do?
I don't know what happened. God, things were perfect. I'm sitting there in the Barca lounger watching Bassmasters like I always do. She's off somewhere in the house doing whatever it is she does, and bam, out of nowhere, she walks in and says, Mikey, we don't communicate.
And that did it.
No, I think it's when I said, I'm sorry, what'd you say?
Well, what exactly did she want to talk about?
I don't know, something about me not being in touch with my emotions.
You know, women say that to me all the time. What the hell are they talking about? I don't know, but I have the feeling if everyone ran around naked in the world, there would be less misunderstanding, you know?
Anyway, Mike, you and Lisa are going to work things out, right? I mean, you have to. You're our big brother. It's your job to set a standard that Billy and I can't live up to.
Would you guys relax? Lisa and I will square this whole thing 2-3 days tops.
Of course you will. Absolutely. Right, Billy? Billy, right?
Well, you know, I can't see into the future, Harry. You know, 2-3 days tops.
Lisa knows you're here?
Yeah, I'm sure she figured it out by now. She's always telling me we're three bodies sharing one brain.
Oh, that's crazy. Where'd she get stuff like that?
Not a clue.
Hey, Mikey, I'm sorry to bother you on the construction site, but I thought you might want to talk about Lisa. Listen, bud, if you're hurting, I'm here for you. No, I'm not accusing you of being sensitive. It's only natural that you would be distraught. Distraught. No, it doesn't mean sensitive. Mikey, we're family. I'm here for you. If you need to talk to me, bye-bye. Lindsay.
Word just came down from Mount Olympus that I have been pronounced the goddess of architecture.
Your blueprints always smell so good.
I just sold a building design that is so brilliant, it will revitalize the entire Chicago skyline. The only thing that mars its perfection is that if someone slams a door too hard, it, well, it could collapse.
Don't you hate when they do that?
Yeah. It's my own fault, you know. I get so wrapped up in the visual aspects of my designs, I occasionally forget about the basics, but the clients never seem to mind. They love me.
Do they love you before or after they're crushed under 26 stories of concrete and steel?
Yeah, well, you see, that's why I need your expertise. I bet none of your buildings fall down.
Well, none that I know of. And again, I don't watch that much news.
You know, upstairs on the 5th floor, when we want to know how much metal stress is on an I-beam, we say Harry Kolchak is the man.
So what, am I the structure guy?
Actually, we call you Mr. Sturdy Man.
Great.
So, can you check out my foundation?
Yeah, when's this due?
Mañana.
What?
Please, please.
Oh, Lindsay, no,
por favor.
No, no, no. Mr. Sturdy Man is swamped with work over here. If I did something like this, it'd take me like 13, 14 hours.
You know what? You're right. You're right. You're right.
I'm sorry.
This is my problem. God, it's so classic what I'm doing. You know, I'm obsessing over work so I don't have to think about my breakup with Derek.
Let me just take a quick look at these for you.
Hey. George Clooney, Antonio Banderas, and Harry Kulchick. What do these three men have in common?
They'll never win an Oscar.
No. Chicks want them.
Fill me in. What happened with Fifth Floor Lindsay?
Poor girl finally broke up with her boyfriend, and I am the happiest man in the Windy City.
Hey, Mike, how's it going with Lisa?
We talking office sex yet?
Well, no, not quite yet, but I do have a game plan.
Oh, for the love of God, stop it, Mike.
Mary, don't tell me you're gonna invite her up to the roof to watch a Cubs game.
You know, some women really enjoy that.
Yeah, a guy can never have too many female best friends.
You guys are talking like I've done this. Six, seven...
Eight
times before. Okay, you're right. Lindsay's finally available. I must act decisively. She's way too important. What I need here is a bold maneuver.
What the hell, a bold maneuver?
Bold maneuver is something that you do that is so startling that someone can't help but see you in a whole new light.
Like the time you shaved down before the swim meet and then found out you didn't make the team?
Exactly like that. Ooh, here it is. Here's the bold maneuver. I'm going to ask her to fly with me this weekend down to New Orleans, where we'll check into a romantic bed and breakfast and eat pralines off each other's naked bodies.
Do nothing. Let her come to you.
You know, Mike, you've been preaching that do-nothing approach since high school. Does that actually work?
Hell yes. It's the foundation of my marriage. I'm gonna shave.
You think I should drive out to Cicero and talk with his wife?
Well, why would you do that?
I'm gonna shave in the bathroom.
Say hi to Lisa for me.
Poor girl.
Harry, what are you doing out here in Cicero, and why are you wearing your brother's jacket?
You know how you're always saying that the Kulchick brothers are basically the same guy?
Yeah.
All right, for the purposes of my little visit, I am your recently estranged husband, Mike.
Okay, go.
All right. Lisa, I'm very sorry for everything that I did wrong as your husband. Forgive me, I love you. Now, please don't make me stay out at Harry's any longer. What time is Bassmasters on?
I'm sorry, Mike. I already told you that we can't get back together unless we go to couples counseling.
Couples counseling? Mm-hmm. Mike Kulchick in couples counseling? No way.
Oh, now you're Harry.
But now I'm every guy.
Look, every guy, I love that you're butting in, but Mike and I have some serious problems.
Yeah, but there's got to be something you can do, Lisa. Did you try everything?
Everything.
You know what my mom and dad used to do when they had problems?
We already tried bowling.
Did you get the shirts?
Enjoy your big brother, Harry. You're going to be living with him for a long time.
You know, Leroy, if you want them really big fish, you stay right by the lily pads and those bass will be jumping on them.
Harry, can I get you some chocolate milk?
Every kind of lunger
Harry?
You can imagine.
Harry? Harry?
Lindsay?
I spent all morning searching for the proper gift to thank you for helping me save my project, and I think I found it. Sex in the building across the street.
What's wrong with right here? Oh!
Okay, Sears Tower, 28th floor, fourth window from the left.
Whoop, whoop, whoop.
Why, Miss Jones, garter belt and stockings under the business suit. Coincidence? I think not.
Apparently, Miss Jones likes to be spanked with a tasseled loafer.
Oh, he's looking for a nice flat surface.
Wow. And I thought I was Mr. Sturdy Man. Damn, mini blinds.
Yeah, just when it was getting good.
Yeah. Want to smoke or snuggle?
I remember Derek tried to do both at once. He set my hair on fire.
Derek, the ex.
Yeah.
Derek. Lindsay, on a related topic, I have a very important question to ask you about how you plan to spend your time during this rebound period.
Well, I don't know. I've got to do something. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, yeah. You cannot believe the level of creeps and psychopaths who come after you when they hear you've broken up with your boyfriend.
Creeps and psychopaths. Yeah.
One jerk actually asked me to fly away with him for the weekend.
Huh? Ew.
Yeah. Maybe someplace like New Orleans, huh?
Nothing that stupid. Oh, I'm sorry, Harry. What was that you wanted to ask me?
Oh, have you ever seen a Cubs game from a roof?
No, I haven't. That's very sweet. I would love to.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right.
You know, every girl deserves a friend like you.
So you did not do the bold maneuver?
Due to circumstances beyond my control, the only intelligent thing to do was to back away from the bold maneuver. But it just so happens that Lindsay is a huge Cubs fan.
Please, Harry, tell me she didn't use the phrase, "I'm lucky to have a friend like you."
I don't know why. I feel like buying drinks. Three beers, please.
Coming right up.
I missed the,
Oh, sorry. Look, I don't normally do this, but it is happy hour, and I thought I'd give you my number, and maybe you call me.
Sorry, I'm married.
Well, if you're sorry you're married, then definitely call me.
It's called the do-nothing approach.
Oh! How weird is this world? A waitress who doesn't even know you throws herself at your feet, and your wife, who loves you, hates your guts.
What's wrong with him?
Gee, I don't know. Maybe something just reminded him that his marriage is falling apart.
At least there wasn't something I said.
Listen up. I know I'm putting my life on the line here, but Lisa wants me to talk to him about going to couples therapy.
Couples therapy?
Yeah.
Doesn't anyone go bowling anymore? Hey, Mikey. Hey, Mike, that was quick. Did you call Lisa?
No, I was checking on the job site. What makes you think I called Lisa?
Okay. Mike, you know when the Bulls are down by 7 points and Jordan and Pippen have to really dig deep to find a way to win?
Are you using a sports metaphor because you think that's the only way to get through to me?
No, of course not. I thought it might help. Mikey, have you and Lisa ever considered couples therapy?
Oh, give me a break. I would never go to couples therapy.
Well, it's a waste to go over to Lisa's.
You went out to see Lisa?
No, Harry did. Well, why are you hitting me?
You're closer. Are you butting into my life?
I'm just trying to help out.
I don't need help, especially from the bold maneuver guy.
Well, Lou Ann, this isn't some waitress. This is your wife here. The do-nothing approach is not working.
Really? What do you know about marriage? Let me tell you something, pal. What goes on between me and Lisa, that's my business. You have crossed the line. And when you cross the line with me, you can't go back.
Just for the record, I was behind you all the way, man.
Guys, this is Gina.
Hello.
You know, that billboard's already working its magic. All of Chicago is asking, who is Gina? And just one of those people happens to host a little local chat show we like to call Oprah.
Oprah?
Way to go, Billy. Hey, everybody, one of Billy's business schemes finally took off. He's representing a star.
Hey. Oh, I can't wait to meet Oprah. He was so cute on the Andy Griffith Show. He's directing now, isn't he?
Never mind. And what can I get you, Gina? I got kielbasa, I got pork ribs, I got a houseboat on Lake Michigan, I got a wife named Joni.
Billy, if you invite a girl that you really like up to the roof, what is the worst thing that could possibly happen?
She brings her ex-boyfriend who she just got back together with.
All right, ta-da!
Hey, Harry. Do you know, if it wasn't for you, Derek and I wouldn't be standing here right now?
Oh, I could just kick myself.
Yeah, the other day, if you didn't help me with that project, I never would have been home in time when Derek showed up with flowers and 2 tickets to New Orleans. I've always wanted to go there.
Face it, Harry, isn't makeup sex the best sex there is?
Sweetie, I think that's a little more than Harry needed to know.
Don't be silly. That is a numero uno getting back together story of all time. Scuse memento. Billy, building on this girl slash ex-boyfriend scenario, what is the worst thing that could happen beyond that?
She and her ex are telling you how they got back together and had great sex.
That's very good. I should take you more seriously. Any word from Mikey?
No, you saw how mad he was. There's no way he's gonna show up.
Yeah, so on the Kolchek family scale, how mad do you think he is at me?
Well, remember how Dad was when Mike Ditka got fired?
He's Ditka mad?
Gina, how can I phrase this delicately? I'm married, but I'm not dead.
Listen, Andy, it just so happens that I'm in a committed relationship right now, and my boyfriend satisfies me so deeply that I don't need to look elsewhere.
Lesbian.
Game time!
Hey, Mikey, you made it.
Harry, look, Mikey's here.
Hey, Harry, everything's gonna be fine.
Except he's gonna jump off the roof.
Mike! There's a chance Lisa might not take me back.
Mike, you wanna back up a little?
I said there's a chance Lisa might not take me back.
No, from the ledge there. You're scaring the hell out of us.
Would you relax? No way I'm gonna jump. The couples counselor made me pay for the first six sessions in advance.
That's great, Mike. So tell us what happened.
Yeah, what happened?
Well, apparently I'm having trouble connecting. I'm hearing, but I'm not listening. I'm watching too much Bassmasters.
Well, the important thing is that you went, huh?
Let me tell you something. Basic training in the Marine Corps was a cakewalk next to that shrink's office.
But you still love Lisa?
What do you think?
I think that you start from there, Mike, you know, and you do whatever it takes.
I'm not saying thanks.
Then don't. I'm not saying I'm sorry.
Then don't.
And I'm not saying I'm embarrassed to have you two as brothers, but I'm thinking it.
There's a guy up there with his head fully submerged in an ice bucket.
Oh, that's Larry. He'll pull it out as soon as the Cubs score.
Oh. Mikey.
Mikey! Mike!
Harry! Is that fifth floor Lindsay of the Not-So-Bold Maneuver?
Don't you just love her?
What are you talking to me for? Go be bold.
You said do nothing.
Hey. The do-nothing approach landed me on your sofa. Go do something.
Lindsay, can I talk to you for a second?
Sure.
I had a completely different picture about this evening.
What do you mean?
Well, in my picture, there was no Derek. It was just gonna be you and me, and I was gonna kiss you right here where we're standing.
Maybe it's better you didn't. Because it probably would have confused me.
Can you hold these for a second?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that definitely would have confused me.
That's a good thing I didn't.
Hi.
Oh. Oh, God.
What exactly is going on here?
Derek, I'll explain it later. It's very confusing.
Okay, well, maybe we can just clear things up, okay?
Hey, that's my brother, man. Okay, here's the deal. There's two ways off this roof. One is the stairs.
There's another way?
What?
Harry, are you okay?
Yeah.
Lindsay, come on, let's get out of here.
When did you start hitting?
Tonight.
You and I have to talk. You
might want to try this couples counselor. She's excellent.
Are you okay?
Yeah.
Good. What the hell were you doing?
You said do something.
Yeah, not swallow her tongue in front of the boyfriend.
You're a little jealous, Mike?
In a partially married kind of way.
Yeah. You know what's really nice about this? Mm. You can see Gina's billboard right in between your two heads there.
Missed a great game.
What game?
How's the jaw?
What jaw?
Looks like Lindsay could be the next member of Team Harry.
Yeah, I don't know, but things are definitely gonna be a little awkward around the office tomorrow.
Well, if they are, I know what I do. Quit that job.
Yeah.
So what's the next move?
Nothing. I do nothing. I don't even think about it.
That's called denial. Therapy word!
Very good. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, we're definitely doing this.
Yeah.